Welcome to the Ambrosia Coaching Radio Show, where we help you to transform from a caterpillar into a butterfly. Please visit us at www.ambrosiacoaching.com. There you will find links to our Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and our blog. My name is Inga Ambrosia, and I'm a certified professional and personal life coach specializing in goal achievement, healthy lifestyle transition, spiritual evolution, law of attraction, and healing love relationships. And I want to welcome you to our program. Hello, hello, everyone. Welcome to the Ambrosia Coaching Radio Show. I would like anyone in the chat room to take a look at the link that I just put in there. It is for tonight's show. We have a special guest, Lynn and Honor. And along with the show, there's a questionnaire for people to fill out. And he's going to talk about that. And before I get him on the line, I'm going to read his little bio that I have in the description. It says, Lynn and Honor is a husband, a father, musician, documentary filmmaker, author, and public speaker. He is married and has four beautiful children and one on the way, which I didn't put in there. Any day now, as a matter of fact. Lynn and Honor has produced a show called Soul Visions Radio, and he has a brand new show called Beloved Is She on the same station. And his latest series focuses on male-female relationships. The name of the video is What is an Honorable Man? How to Attract One, and Knowing That You Are Worthy. I want everyone to check out his website, which is www.linenhonor.com. That is LENONHONOR.com. And this is a four-part DVD series. I have seen it. It is amazing. And let me see if I can get him on the line so we can... Welcome, Lynn and Honor.
Hey, Inga, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Oh, just wonderful. I'm so happy to be with you. I'm excited, and thank you so much for having me on your show.
Of course. I wanted to let everyone know I have known Lynn for, is it 2 or 3 years?
From the beginning.
That's true. Yes, I discovered your videos by mistake. I was looking for something else. And then okay. I think it was the one about Michael Jackson.
Oh, yes.
What Lies in Plain Sight. And after that, I've seen everything.
Yes, it's been quite an adventure and quite a journey. So it's been about almost three years, I would say. Almost about 3 years.
Excellent. So for the people in the chat room and online that don't know Lynn and Honor as well as I do and the rest of the people that, you know, are fans of yours, tell us a little history about you.
Oh, sure, sure. Well, my name is Lynn and Honor. the first thing and the most important thing is I am an absolutely dedicated husband and father to four children and another baby on the way, which we are expecting in about a month. And though over the last few years, we have gone on quite an adventure in terms of information and radio shows, videos, documentaries, vlogs, you name it. I still stand here before you and everyone else as a testament to the reality that there are, in fact, good men out there. And above all else, I want that to be known about me, and I want that to be known by all women, that there is an abundance of good men on planet Earth. So much of my earlier work, it dealt more with media and media mind control, media propaganda, and how it impacts how we think. Interesting enough, a lot of that programming impacts how we see ourselves in terms of male-female relationships. A lot of that program, it impacts men in terms of how they perceive women. It impacts women in terms of how they perceive men. It impacts the nature of our relationships. It impacts the value that we place on ourselves as human beings. And it impacts what we, the value that we place on the family institution all the way across the board. So my earlier work, it dealt mainly with the programming, the media mind control programming. However, in more recent months, I've tried to kind of steer away from those topics and I've sought to address issues related to personal development and personal growth. And that's where I'm at now. So much of my work now on linenhonor.com, it deals with, you know, personal growth, personal refinement, and elevating oneself from the inside out. And that's what I'm trying to promote here today.
Excellent. So tell us about the series. How did you actually come up with the idea to do it?
Yes. The lecture series is What is an Honorable Man? How to Attract One in Knowing That You Are Worthy. And there's a sister, her name is Spirit Halima, who had suggested that I do a lecture series on the topic. And I've been hesitant to address particular issues, especially related to women's issues, because I just never felt like I really had anything of value to offer. But I've had to deal with my own self-esteem issues, and I've had to come to grips with the reality that I do have something to offer that can benefit women. And her inspiration and her support and guidance really set me on course to putting together this lecture series, a four-part lecture series. And we tackle many different topics. And I actually enjoy watching it, which says a lot.
Yeah, no, I do too. I do too. It's very invaluable. It really is a male perspective. You know, it's, you have much to offer.
Oh, thank you. And I think it's important for males to speak on women's issues. Because not enough males venerate women in the manner in which they should be venerated. And so me as a husband, my wife and I, we recently celebrated our 10-year anniversary. And I have nothing but the utmost respect for my wife and what she has accomplished and, you know, the beauty that she has brought into my life. And I recognize that it has been women who have steered me on course to where I can become what I have become. And so, therefore, I think it's important for males who have a clear perspective and who see women in a very much positive light to speak on issues related to women. And it took me a while to get to the point where I feel comfortable enough to do that, but I am there now, and I'm thankful.
Excellent. Can we talk a little bit about the questionnaire that we put in the chat room?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, so as an introduction to the lecture series, I put together a small questionnaire. I think it's about 9, maybe 10 questions on there. And this questionnaire is really an introductory. It's more to have women kind of think about particular topics that we may not necessarily think about. Oftentimes, what we're kind of led along to think about in terms of male-female relationships is, what is the quality of that man in terms of his interaction with me? How does he look? Do I look my best for him? what can he give to me? What can he provide for me? But getting to the core issues of what is an honorable man, that's very important, because when we understand what an honorable man is, and each woman must define that for themselves, when you define those qualities that you consider to be honorable, you set a stage and you set a precedence in terms of what you're willing to accept from men. And it's an affirmation to the universe as to what you expect and what you are demanding and what you believe that you are, that you know that you are deserving of. So I put together a small quick questionnaire here. And the first question on there is in 10 sentences or less, describe what an honorable man is to you. And I'll invite all women who are listening to the show, do this exercise. Just write down 10 sentences and describe what an honorable man is to you. You can be as clear as you can possibly be. And that sets the foundation, because what that functions as an affirmation to the universe in terms of what an honorable man is, this is what I define it as being. And that it goes a long way in terms of getting to the point where you can say, this is what I want and this is what I deserve and this is what I am worthy of. So that's the first part, is in 10 sentences or less, describe what an honorable man is to you. And then the second part is, list 5 qualities of an honorable man and describe why each of these qualities is important to you. So whatever 5 qualities you come up with, also describe why each of these qualities is important to you. And that's very important, because you, as women, it's important for you to be clear in terms of what is important to you, as opposed to what media may have. Yeah, what media may have told you what is supposed to be important for women. OK, you get a man who has a good job. You get a man who can support you. You get a man who looks a certain kind of way. OK, well, that's all fine and good. But that doesn't get to the core issues of what it means to be an honorable man. So you have to be clear in terms of what qualities are important to you. So those are the first two. And then there's There's maybe about seven more, and I don't know if you want me to go through the rest of them or not. It's totally up to you.
You can. You can go through them briefly. Oh. I had some questions on some of them, so that would be good.
Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. So I'll go through them real quickly here. And this is downloadable on my website, too. So if any of you all want to download it from my website, I have it there. You can download it and fill it out for yourself. And this is kind of introduction to the actual DVD set. The third question is, write down the names of men that you consider to be honorable.
Questionnaire. And I thought I was just going to zip through it. And I actually had to sit and think about every single question and be completely honest.
Yes. What about this one? Did it come easy to write down the names of men that you consider to be honorable?
Well, at first, automatically, I put my father. That's right. The very first one. But then after that, I was comparing people to my father. And then I had to look back at questions one and two and rethink why I thought they were honorable. So I had to like put them through a little mini trial in my brain, like, oh, were they really honorable? So I had to work on my list, and it actually, the people that I put on my list were not people that I had dated. They were all family.
Wow, that's very interesting. And I know I filled out what I could, because some of these questions I can't fill out as a man, but as you know, this particular question. I couldn't find too many, and I really, you know, on some level I felt bad about that, but I had to also be honest about that as well. So I think for men and women, I think that's an important question. How many, write down the names of men that you consider to be honorable. The next part of the question is list five strategies that you have employed in the past to attract men and describe why you used each of those strategies. That's a difficult question.
Yeah.
Yes, because part of what I talk about in the lecture series is what women can do strategically to attract an honorable man. And there's a difference between a boy, attracting a boy. There's a difference between that and attracting a man or a male. And there's a difference between attracting a male and attracting a man. There's a difference between attracting a man and an honorable man. An honorable man is someone who has consistently exhibited high levels of respect and honor towards women, and that in his everyday action, he is in service to women. So that level of becoming an honorable man is very important. So the manner in which women strategize in terms of attracting a prospective mate, or the strategies that she uses, is going to directly impact whether or not she's going to attract unto her a boy, a male, a man, or an honorable man. So what I provide is five strategies that women can use to attract an honorable man, because that's the ultimate goal. You don't want to sell yourself short, and you definitely don't want to settle for anything that is less than deserving of you. So it's important to strategize in terms of attracting the best possible mate, which happens to be an honorable man. So I wrote down here, list down five strategies that you have employed in the past to attract men, and then describe why you used each of those strategies. And one of the reasons it's important to describe why we use, or a woman may have used those types of strategies, because some of those strategies are faulty and they're simply given to us via media.
Media programming. So it's important. And so it's important to transcend that level of programming. And the next question is really important. Describe the degree of success or failure that each of these strategies has had in attracting honorable men. Also describe why these strategies were either successful or unsuccessful. And the idea is that when you're clear in terms of the strategy that you used that brought into your space an honorable man, then you should hold on to that. And then those strategies that didn't necessarily, you know, may have brought you, you know, hardship in a male that was disrespectful towards you, or a male that didn't necessarily resonate on a particular level, or a male that wasn't deserving of you, then whatever strategy you employed to attract those types of males, then those strategies must be let go of. So it's really a filtration process, and this is part of the personal refinement that we must all go through. And as women, in terms of attracting a prospective mate, you should also seek to refine the strategies that you use to attract an honorable man.
Yeah, a lot of the strategies we're given, you know, as young girls, either being told that or just seeing what other people do, and what we're actually doing is attracting dishonorable men. But in our minds, those are plentiful, and if we don't go after them, then we're going to be alone. We have this fear that, okay, well, I can't sit around and wait for this honorable guy to show up and notice me, so I have to take Mr. Right Now. You know, sometimes out of desperation, we pretty much take whatever's around. And I was going to ask you, how does trauma you know, having bad experiences with men affect your ability to attract an honorable man? I mean, is it something that we're giving off this this broken state, a lower vibration?
Of course. And I make it very clear in the lecture series that you can only attract what you deserve, and you can only attract the masculine representation of who and what you are right now.
Mm-hmm.